ओके क्लास, सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अ बस स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम रेस्ट विद अ कांस्टेंट एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ 5 meters per second square. नाउ एट द सेम टाइम अ कार ट्रैवलिंग विद अ कांस्टेंट वेलोसिटी ऑफ 50 meters per second ओवरटेक्स एंड पासिस द बस. फाइन, डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन? A bus has started from rest, so we can say that in case of bus, initial velocity will be equal to zero, and it is traveling with a constant acceleration of 5 meters per second square. So what do we do in a question? We always write down whatever is given to us. So u or initial velocity will be zero in this case. Fine. And what is the acceleration? It is 5 meters per second square. Now what else is given? At the same time a car traveling with a constant velocity. Now this all was about bus. Fine. Now what about car? When we talk about car, only the constant velocity of that car is given, which is equals to 50 meters per second. Fine. It overtakes and passes the bus. Now we have to first find out the distance with will the bus overtake the car. Okay, so we suppose that the bus overtakes the car. The car after covering distance, let us suppose it is equal to s. Okay, let us suppose the distance covered by a car will be equal to bus will be equal to s when it overtakes the car. Now there will come a point when these two will meet. So when the two meet, it means the bus and the car, they both meet, what will be the time taken? Time taken t will be same. Yes, when both these cars are meeting at a point, the time taken t will be same in that case. So we will first write the value of distance covered, because we have to find out the distance. So for bus, what will be the distance? How will we calculate it? We know that second equation of motion is s is equals to ut plus half at square. Fine. And in case of bus, u is 0, a is 5 meters per second square. So we'll put the values here. What we'll get? 0 plus half. What is the value of a? 5 meters per second. So 5 into t square. So we can say that here the value of distance is equals to 5 by 2 t square. Fine. Now in case of car, if we find the distance for car, what will be the distance in this case? We all know that speed is equal to distance upon time. You can also use the formula for velocity here. And the speed is given to us, or velocity is given to us, which is equal to 50 meter per second. So we'll put the value here, 50 meter per second. What is the distance in this case? Do we know the distance? No, we have to find out the distance. Let us suppose it is s. And what is the time? Time will be equal to, we don't know the time also, so t. Fine. So the distance will be equal to 50 t. Okay. Now we will find out the distance s. How we will find out? As the two distances covered by the bus and the car will be equal in time t, time taken by these two will be same and the distance covered will be same. So by using these two equations, we will say that 5 by 2 t square will be equal to 50 t. Fine. On solving this, what we will get? Give us 10. So t is equal to 20 seconds. Okay, we can say that the time taken is equal to 20 seconds. Fine. Now we have to, what we have to further find? we have to find this distance. This is t, because with the help of t we will be able to find the distance. Now we had to find the distance the bus will overtake. What was the equation for distance? It is equals to 50t. So by putting the value of time in this, we will find out the distance. 5 into 2 will give you 10. So we can say that the distance covered by the bus in time t, which is equals to 20 seconds, is equals to 1000 meter. Fine. Now secondly, what we have to find here, we have to find the how fast will the bus be traveling then. Okay, now after overtaking the car, how far this bus will travel. So to find out how far this bus will travel, we will use third equation of motion, which is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. We all know that u is equal to 0 in case of bus. So we will put the value here, so it will become 0 square plus 2. And what is acceleration given to us? It is 5 meter per second square. We will put the value here. And what is the distance? We have just find out 1000. Fine. Multiplying this, 5 2s are 10 into 1000 will give us 10,000. Okay. This is equal to v square. But we have to find the value of v. How fast will the bus be traveling then? Means we have to find the velocity of the bus after it overtakes the car. So if we find the square root of this, what we'll get? 10,000 is the square root of 100. So the velocity, once the bus overtakes the car, it will be equal to 100 meter per second. Okay, I hope you all understood this.